So if this red line is our principal component, then the information loss is going to be something like the sum of all of these distances that I'm drawing in here, the distance between the points and their new projected spots on the new feature on the line. And we can sum this up over all the points. We'll get some number. And here's the key insight. Let me draw in another principal component that we could have hypothesized as the first principal component, as the one we wanted to use. Let's suppose that instead of the red line, we were looking at this purple line instead. Then we can ask the same question of the purple line. What's the information loss when we project all of the points down onto it? And we'll start to get something that looks like this. Now it's a little bit cluttered, but I hope what you can see is that on average, these purple lines are all going to be significantly longer than the red lines. For any given point, that might not be true, but for the points in aggregate, it will be true that when we maximize the variance, we're actually minimizing the distance between the points and their new spot on the line. In other words, it's a mathematical fact that when we do this projection onto the direction of maximal variance and only onto that direction, we'll be minimizing the distance from the old point to the new transformed point. And what this is necessarily doing is minimizing the information loss.